Today we're talking about the importance of giving grief a voice. What's up, VIPs? Derek here, back with another video. And, you know, we've talked about grief in the past. Grief, the sense of loss, all that sort of thing that goes with loss in life, whether it's sight loss or loss of a loved one or something like that. Talked about it from a lot of different angles, but I think that this idea of giving grief a voice is so important. And I want to share a quote I heard recently from a blog I read that I think can be really impactful and remind us how we can sort of skip over things and not give grief a voice. By the way, if you're new around here, my name is Derek, and I help people just like you to discover life after sight loss. Here we do product reviews, life advice, encouragement, how-tos, and so much more. So I'd love for you to consider subscribing, following, liking, and all that other good stuff so you don't miss another single video. Now, recently, I was introduced to a blog called Navigating Blindness, and I'm going to leave a link down in the description for that. But the gal that writes that blog sent me a message and was talking about it. She's the mother of a 16-year-old who has retinitis pigmentosa, and she's talking about, you know, just how to navigate that whole world of being a parent of somebody with visual impairment. Now, it's a pretty new blog. She doesn't have a bunch of stuff up there yet, but she wrote a post about, you know, sight loss and the 16th birthday and that sort of thing. And it was really good. And there was a quote in there that I want to give to you today because I think it was so impactful. So it's about grief. And you can read the, again, link in the description of all this. But let me give it to you. It says this: I need to be careful not to skip over the grief by silver lining it. Grief is important and needs a voice. And that guy's name is Kim Owens. So she talks about how she doesn't need to skip over the grief by silver lining it. I think a lot of times we do tend to offer that, you know, thing of grief. Like, well, just think, it could be worse. You know, we say that a lot of times. It could be worse. It could be this. And we try to silver line everything. Well, everything's great. Everything's okay. And at least you're not dead. Or, you know, whatever we say to make ourselves feel better, we silver line it. And this quote says, we need to be careful not to do that because grief needs a voice. You need to be able to not just verbally say, I am sad, I am grieving, whatever the case is, but give it an outlet. You know, whether that's doing something, talking to a therapist or a counselor, finding a way to, you know, I don't know, just get that stuff out. Like, that's really the thing that I think most people forget about, is that grief is going to be there. It just is. It doesn't matter if you're rich or poor. It doesn't matter your social status. Doesn't matter your level of education. Grief happens. And we have to give it a voice. We can't just avoid it by trying to be super positive or whatever the case. And I've talked about in other videos about being positive about things. And you can be positive, but you have to be honest about it. And you have to give grief that voice. So I think this right here, this quote, is a good reminder. This comes from a mother of somebody who's going through sight loss themselves, who's eventually going to lose all their sight because RP typically does that. And so this mother is just trying to work her way through her own grief journey, through her son's grief journey, all that sort of thing. And just a reminder to herself and to all of us that we don't need to just silver line things. We don't want to avoid grief by silver lining it. We want to give grief a voice. So my question for you today is, what is one way you have given grief a voice? Do you talk about it with a counselor or a mentor? Do you work on things? Do you have a physical outlet? What is something that you have done to give grief a voice? I would love to hear about it, and I know others would as well, so let me know in the comments below. Hey, if you like this video, if you found it helpful, make sure to show your support and give it a big thumbs up and share it out with somebody that you know. And if you're watching this on YouTube, I would love for you to subscribe to my channel and turn on notifications so you don't miss another single video. Thanks so much for watching wherever you are, and until next time, remember that sight loss isn't the end, it's just the beginning. My name's Derek Daniel from LifeAfterSightLoss.com, and I'll see you in the next one.